Welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the vlog. Today you join me at the start of a couple of days of adventures, and I'm in a place right now called Glengarriff, and it's Glengarriff Nature Reserve. It's a place that I've come to a couple of years back actually, and I failed miserably. My photographs were only okay, but I failed in the vlog because I had the audio completely wrong. I was using a boom mic and it was actually pointing down towards the water, so all it was taking was the sound of the water. But now I've arrived back a couple of years later, more experience under my belt, and hopefully a couple of new tricks and tools as well that I've learned over the years to enable me to get more from the scene. What I have here is this beautiful lagoon with a waterfall coming down into it. Now, I was expecting it to have a bit more water because it has been raining quite a lot for the last number of days, but maybe not here. But with the flow that we have here as well, I think it will be quite nice, because what I'm going to try and do is get down low and get close enough to the water so you kind of have the water dominating the base of the frame, but then leading up to the waterfall in the distance. What that should do also is to kind of give me a bit of reflection as well of the waterfall in the actual slack water. But it'll be an interesting couple of days anyway. It'll be an interesting start to this trip, because maybe I can do better than I did the last time. So yeah, let's go, let's see how I get on, and I'll show you and I'll talk you through the compositions as I find them. Come down now rather low, like I said, to be able to take this shot, and the sun is giving me some highlights, so I'm having to deal with those. But what I am doing is putting on the polarizer, which is removing most of the sheen that I'm able to see, that it's taking the focus within the frame. The waterfall I've got in two different types of compositions. So first type of composition I've done is a traditional landscape, and now I've moved as well to a portrait. And by using the portrait, I can put that waterfall at the camera at a slight angle, so it'll kind of accentuate the height of the waterfall in the distance. It'll be on the top part of the frame as well. Settings at the moment, actually, I'm at f16, and I'm aiming to try and get anywhere between half a second and 1 second exposure. Now, I might as well change out and put on a full ND and see if I can really smooth out that water as well. See what that type of photograph anyway is like. But yeah, for a first composition anyway, it's a really, really nice spot. It's perfectly calm as well, so you know, I'll be able to play around here, take my time. There's nobody else here as well, so which is great. And I'll be able to play around, look for some different compositions. I want to utilize as well the banks that I see either side here, try and frame them up. I have my welly boots on, so I'm able to walk into the water, which is good. But there's a composition over here on the left-hand side where there's a tree that's growing on a rock. And if I can try and frame that photograph, I think it might be a nice photograph as well. So we'll head over there to there next. I'll continue on here. I'll put on the ND. I'll see what that type of shot looks like. And then I'll show you the results of that. And then we'll talk when we come back over there. Before I head over there to get that photograph with the tree, I decided to put on my long lens, because when I was reviewing the images and I zoomed in to make sure that I was in focus on the waterfall, I spotted a nice frame that I decided that, you know what, get out the long lens, zoom right into it, and do exactly the same thing as I was doing a moment ago. Do a relatively quick shutter speed with a polarizer, and then also put on a ND and get a long exposure as well. And I think it's going to be a nice photograph. The light right now actually is perfect because it's nice and flat where the waterfall is. A bit of lighter light shining on me at the moment, but that's fine because I'm not photographing that area. And the settings that I'm going for at the moment here, I'm at F10, and I'm up as far as a 30 second exposure. So that's the longer one. And then I'll dial that back and I'll go for around a half a second exposure as well, just to be able to keep a bit of motion within that water as well also. But I definitely think it'll be a nice shot. Definitely think I've learned a couple of things over the years as well to enable me to think about this, because normally I'd come with my wide lens, take a couple of photographs and off I'd be gone. But by looking within the scene and picking out some vignettes of images as well, it's something that I've learned over the years. So yeah, I think that will be a nice second shot anyway. I'll show you that, and then we are going to head over to that tree and we're going to get that final shot as well from there. I've come over here now by this tree that's growing onto this rock, and I think it's going to be a nice photograph. I've taken, again, landscape orientation, portrait orientation. I've taken a long exposure, I've taken a short exposure, and I'll play around then and see which one I like when I get back to base. But it's always good to take multiple types of shots when you're on site, because obviously you can't do that again when you get home. One of the things actually that I've noticed here is when I'm taking the portrait orientation shot, I'm getting this branch that's in a tree that's coming up and over and framing the actual shot, but I'm getting a lot of sky as well within that. So I'm probably going to have to take multiple exposures, one anyway particularly for the sky, so that's not blown out, because obviously it's dark in the canopy of the trees as well. But yeah, I think this shot will be nice. I'm fixing myself at around f11 as well to get a good depth of field in each of the images. But with the framing that I have here, you'd have this tree which is growing out of the rock, like I say, on the left hand side. You've got the waterfall behind that. You can't really see the main waterfall from this angle, but that's fine because you can get the extent of it, because there's another waterfall in the middle. So it's kind of three waterfalls in the one frame. It's a nice shot, I think, anyway. I hope it'll be nice when I get it back to base. But yeah, I'll show you the shot here. There's one other one now I think I want to get, try and capture some roots of the trees as well. So yeah, we'll go on to that place now next, and that'll be the final shot then as well from this location. Final shot now for today. Come up to the bank here, and there's these roots from this tree actually here that are spreading down in the direction of the waterfall. You've got two big boulders as well that are on the base of the bank. Now, one of them is quite imposing, and it might actually be blocking the eye from going through the image, but I'm not sure. Looking in the back of the camera, it looks okay, but it also does look quite imposing within the frame. Again, same settings I would have done earlier on. Polarizer, taking a shot with the long, with the ND for long exposure. And I'm only going to go for portrait orientation, I think, here. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go for landscape as well while I'm at it. But yeah, good to always get back to locations that you've been to before. Hopefully I've improved now from what I would have done when I was here before. I'm going to finish up this episode of my vlog. Thank you very much, as always, for joining me. If it's your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing, give me a like, give me a comment. And until the next time, Schlange Folge.